Hello there, this is Msangi for jishinde.com, and today we are going to look at entitlements and permission sets. Business Central has created a very good way of handling upgrades. That is, you can create permissions and in code. So when you create a permission in code using the entitlement object permission set or the permission set extension, you will be able to now do upgrade easier, because when you upgrade you have the permission in code form, so you don't need to now upgrade the data. And it's also safer to have the permission as something that can't be changed, because data can easily be manipulated. Someone can be denied permissions or added some permissions which are not legit. So there is an entitlement object. This entitlement object will give you permissions based on your role in Azure. But again, this will mostly apply for the online version of Business Central. Let me just peep in through. There is something that says the entitlement is associated with an Azure AD role, that when the type is role, the role type property is used to distinguish between the local and delegated assignments of the role, which in this case is delegated. The object entitlements property, now this is a property that we really need to look at. So when you're using the online version of Business Central, define the list of permissions that the entitlements include. So all the permissions will be listed under this object entitlements. So it's a way of grouping the permissions, the way we're using user groups, but now in code you can use entitlements to do the grouping. Okay, but for today we look at the permission set object directly from Visual Studio Code, and we will use this example that has been created here. So you use the snippet t permission set, and there is this property that I believe you're familiar with, and if not, this is read, insert, modify, delete. So you define the permission that is given to that particular object using those four variables. Okay. So like you can see this one, there's another key property here, assignable. Assignable means that is this permission assignable? If it's, it can be assignable, or where is it? You can have it like an included permission set. It can be like a permission set that you use now to include in the main permission set. It will not have the assignable property to be true. So if you want to include it as part of our permissions, that you will not set it as assignable, but you will set the included permission set property to this particular permission to be able to assign it. And so let's go to the code, because a lot of talking without code will make us not be able to do much. So I'll just copy this for the purpose of saving time, so that I may not type a lot. So if you're creating from scratch, you just use the t permission set snippet, and then you put in the id, let's say, okay, whichever id, and then the name. You see now this assignable is true by default, it comes to true, and then included permission sets comes by default if you want to have an included, and then now it's the object type, object name, and then the object permissions that will be identified there. So maybe we can just add one thing here, because this is the salesperson. They've been given customer. Okay, let me just give them reminders. The table that reminder terms. Let me just say they need the reminder terms to remind the customers when they have issues with them. So we are not giving them delete, read, insert, modify for that reminder terms. So I will save this, compile, and then now we'll be able to assign this permission set to the user. So it has been published to the server. So now we'll be able to refresh the permission set and we'll see the name of our permission, that is cell person. Where is it? Cell person. Yeah, here it is. We have the permission and the type is system, meaning it came from the code, like it's already, it's like a system permission. When we click on this and to see the permission, you see the reminder terms, we have it there. It is read permission, insert, modify, delete. But now we cannot be able to add a new value. You cannot be able to delete. Like, let me try deleting this. This one will not be, I'll not be able to. Okay, I'm not even given the option to do that. So, okay, the permission sets of type system cannot be changed. Only permission sets of type user defined can be changed. Okay, the system is also notifying us that there is nothing that we can do to make a change to this permission set. And this is a very safe way of creating permission, that you know that when defined, nobody or no one can change. Even the security filter, I don't know. Let me try. Yeah, you can't change anything. I think I should look into how you can define the security filter in the permission set. This is where if you want to define a specific field that or a specific maybe dimension that for that particular data set that the user with that permission should access, you can use that security filter to determine. They're saying specify the security filter for being applied to the permission set to limit the access that this permission set has to the contained data in this table. Yeah, you limit to what is contained in the table. And I believe that is it with permission sets. If there is something missing that I have not touched on permission sets, we'll proceed in the next video, but I think we'll look at user groups and how to assign those permissions on the client side and the best practices, including the UI removal tool. If you want to remove the elements that are okay, the UI elements for users without those permissions in Business Central. So God bless, and I will see you in the next video.